Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pie My Life Up. In this video, we'll be showing you how to easily set up a WIreGuard VPN server on your device using Docker. Traditionally, setting up a WIreGuard server can be a bit tricky. Luckily, thanks to the WGEasy Docker container that we will be using, this whole process is made incredibly simple, and with its web interface, you can easily manage and create new VPN clients. Please note, before you continue any further, there's two things you'll want to do. First, you'll need to know the public IP address of your device. If you're running this from within your home, you'll want to make sure that you have DHCP reservations set up to ensure your device gets the same local IP address every time. Secondly, you will need to port forward the port 51820 when running this within your home network. Once you are ready to proceed, open up the terminal on your machine, either directly or through SSH. Our first step is to update the package list by typing sudo apt update. Once the package list is updated, upgrade any out-of-date packages by typing in sudo apt upgrade-y. Our next step is to install Docker onto your machine so we can easily set up the WIreGuard VPN. If you already have Docker installed, you can skip the next couple of steps. To install the latest version of Docker, we will first want to install curl by typing in sudo apt install curl-wire. We will use curl to grab and run the Docker install script. We can do this by typing curl space hyphen S capital L space https:// get.docker.com followed by the pipe symbol followed by sh. Once Docker finishes installing, we will want to add our current user to the Docker group by typing in sudo space user mod space hyphen A capital G space Docker space $ and then user all in uppercase. Adding your user to this group allows you to interact with Docker without using super user privileges. Now, to ensure the rest of your system is aware of this change, reboot it by typing in sudo space reboot and pressing enter. With Docker now installed, we can move on to setting up the WIreGuard VPN server Docker container. We'll start this off by making a directory to store the compose file and the config files for WIreGuard. To do this, type in sudo space mkdir space hyphen p space /opt/stacks/WIreGuard. Once created, change the directory by typing in sudo space /opt/stacks/WIreGuard. Before we begin writing the compose file for our WIreGuard VPN container, we will need to generate a password for it. WGEasy expects this to be a hash of the password you want to use. Luckily, it provides some tools we can run that will generate the proper hash for you. Let's generate this password by typing in docker space run space hyphen hyphen rm space hyphen it space ghcr.io slash wg hyphen easy slash wg hyphen easy space wgpw followed by a single quote followed by your password, which we'll be using Pie My Life Up for our example, followed by a single quote. Docker will now download the WGEasy container and execute the command we specified. Once the container finishes running, you should see a line starting with password underline hash. Copy this entire line by selecting it and pressing Ctrl+Shift+C. You will need this for the next step. Now that we have the hash for the password we want to use to interact with the WGEasy web interface, we can now begin writing the Docker compose file by typing in sudo space nano space compose.yaml. Before we continue, indentation is incredibly important to the YAML format. Make sure you replicate what we do within this file. Start this file by specifying a new list of services by typing in services followed by the colon symbol. Underneath this, begin defining the WGEasy container by typing in wg-easy followed by the colon symbol. We can now give this container a name by typing in container underline name colon followed by wg-easy. Next, we need to tell Docker what image to use by typing in image colon symbol space ghcr.io slash wg-easy slash wg-easy. Next up, we need to specify a new list of environment variables for our WIreGuard VPN Docker container. To do this, type in environment followed by the colon symbol. Underneath this, type in hyphen and then paste in the password underline hash variable you got earlier. You can paste within the terminal by pressing Ctrl+Shift+V. From this line, you will need to make some changes before it is ready. First, for every dollar sign symbol, add another dollar sign next to it. This means there should be three lots of dollar signs you need to adjust. Finally, you will need to remove the single quotes from this line. There's one at the start of your password hash and one at the end. Next up, we need to tell WIreGuard what your host IP address will be. This should be the external IP address that you use to access your WIreGuard VPN. Do not use a local IP address here unless you only want this VPN to work within your local home network. To set this variable, type in hyphen space WG underline host equals sign followed by the IP address you want your VPN to be accessed through. Our next step is to list the volumes we want mounted to our WG Easy Docker container. To define this list of volumes, type in volumes followed by the colon symbol. Now define our first volume by typing in hyphen space dot slash config followed by the colon symbol followed by /etc/WIreGuard. This volume mounts the configuration from WIreGuard to your local machine and allows it to persist through restarts. Next, for WIreGuard to work properly, this container will need access to kernel modules. With Linux, WIreGuard is implemented at a kernel level. Luckily, giving our Docker container access to these modules is fairly easy. To do this, type in /lib/modules, followed by the colon symbol /lib/modules. Next, we must specify the ports we want to expose from our WIreGuard VPN Docker container. To start this list, type in ports followed by the colon symbol. To find our first port by typing in hyphen space double quote followed by 51820 colon symbol 51820 /UDP followed by a double quote. This is the port that our WIreGuard VPN server will use for its connections. Next, type in hyphen followed by double quote 51821 colon symbol 51821 followed by /TCP and then a double quote. This port is used for WG Easy's web interface. This web interface is what makes using WIreGuard incredibly easy. It allows you to easily create new clients and manage them. We can ensure Docker will keep our WIreGuard VPN server up and running by typing in restart colon symbol space unless hyphen stopped. Essentially, this tells Docker to continually restart the container if it ever crashes. Next, we need to give this container a few more privileges that aren't typically given to Docker containers. To do this, type in cap underline add followed by the colon symbol. Underneath this new list, type in hyphen space net underline admin. This new capability allows our WIreGuard VPN server to manage the network of the host system. After this, type in hyphen space sys underline module. This final capability allows our Docker container to interact with the kernel modules. Our final task for this file is to specify a new list called sysctls followed by a colon symbol. This section allows us to modify kernel parameters when the Docker container starts up. Under this list, type in hyphen space net.ipv4.ip_forward=1 followed by hyphen net.ipv4.conf.all.source_valid_mark=1. These two changes essentially help the Linux system deal with the WIreGuard VPN connections. With this file written, save and quit by pressing Ctrl+X, then Y, and then Enter. Now all we need to do to start up our WIreGuard VPN server is to type in docker space compose space up space hyphen D and press Enter. With the container now up and running, you will want to access its web interface. If you have forgotten your IP, type in hostname space hyphen capital I to retrieve it. Now open up your favorite web browser and type in http followed by the colon symbol /, followed by the IP address you got previously, followed by the port 51821. If everything has worked perfectly, you should now have access to the WG Easy web interface. Use the password field here to type in the password you set when writing the Docker Compose file. With the password entered, click the sign in button. The first thing you'll want to do is create your first client for your WIreGuard VPN server. To do this, click New in the top right corner of the screen, and then type in a name for your new client. In our case, we'll call ours PyMy WIreGuard VPN, and then click the Create button. With that done, we have created our first client configuration. Now, to actually connect to this server, you will even need to use the QR code, which you can get by clicking the QR code symbol, or you can download the WIreGuard config file by clicking the download button. Another neat thing about using WG Easy is that you can easily backup your configuration by clicking the backup button. You can then just import this backup into any other installation of WG Easy. At this point, you should now have a WIreGuard VPN server up and running on your machine thanks to Docker. As you have seen, WG Easy makes managing a WIreGuard VPN server incredibly easy, even for beginners. If you like this tutorial, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.